the robot approach that acts as an aircraft carrier. The motion of the multi-legged Velociraptoroba is a symphony of chaos. Pick it up and watch its tiny, half-circle-shaped legs scuttle about. You might think it wouldn't get very far very fast. But this tiny bundle of circuits and plastic is tuned to harness its wiggle and wobble to stabilize itself. The little bobs run fast enough to serve as aircraft carriers to robo-birds. You see, Berkeley's 32-gram Velociraptor is reaching the blistering speed of 1.3 meters per second, 2.9 miles per hour, calculated to lift the 13.2-gram H2 bird, a micro-aerial vehicle, off the ground. The demonstration goes beyond showing off adorable RC creatures. There is a real benefit in studying how robots could work together. Why don't we have commercially available flying cars? One of the reasons is that it's hard to make machines that are really good at multiple jobs. If you want to drive fast, you need a big, heavy engine, but if you also then want to fly, you need to be light. That's the compromise of engineering. The alternative is something like the Velociraptor and H2 bird pairing. Robot teams hauling the H2 bird around on its back is going to make Velociraptor less efficient, IEEE reports, but it also improves stability, decreasing pitch and roll variances by up to 95% if H2 bird slowly flaps its wings at 5 Hz while Velociraptor is running. The H2 bird's slow flapping before takeoff also effectively decreases the weight of the duo, increasing the roach's running speed by 12%. Still, there is a trade-off. The roach's quicker cousin, the X2 Velociraptor, runs really fast without any encumbrances. Seriously, blink and you'll miss it. Okay, 17.6 km per hour, 11 miles per hour isn't supercar speed, but it is the fastest robot for its size. The versions of the Velociraptor and the H2 bird aren't yet autonomous, and the H2 bird can't yet make a landing on its roach launcher, but those capabilities can't be far off.